Gentleman from Florida.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Your permission, Mr. Attorney General, I'd like to follow the chairman's questions regarding Mr. Iglesias. If I understand it correctly, you testified that Karl Rove talked to you about voter fraud in New Mexico in fall 2006?
Yes, New Mexico and two other jurisdictions, that's correct.
Mr. Iglesias is selected for the termination list in early November 2006?
I think on Election Day. His name, well, I don't know when he was selected. I wasn't involved in that process.
Right. It appears on the list. Looking at the documents, it first appears
on the list on Election Day.
And it's your testimony, you did not select Mr. Iglesias to be put on the list, correct?
His name was brought forward to me, recommended, right. along with others.
You did not select him. Did Mr. Sampson select him?
Mr. Sampson was charged with coordinating this effort.
He didn't select him.
I have not spoken with Mr. Sampson about this.
Did former Deputy Attorney General Mr. Comey, did he select him?
Of course, he wasn't in the department at that time.
So he didn't select.
I don't think he selected him.
That's right. Did Mr. McNulty select him?
I haven't asked that question, Mr. McNulty.
Mr. McNulty told us he didn't select him. Did Mr. Margolis select him?
Again, I haven't spoken with Mr. Margolis.
We've talked a lot about the president's authority to have who he wants where. Did the president select Mr. Iglesias to be put on the termination list?
No,
the president didn't select him. Did the vice president select him to put him, Mr. Iglesias, on the termination list?
No.
No. Okay, so the president didn't, the vice president didn't, you, the attorney general, didn't, all of the assistant and former deputy attorney generals didn't put Mr. Iglesias on the termination list. So who did?
Well, what's important, Congressman, is that there was a consensus recommendation made to me. Whether or not how we got on the list is less important.
So a group of people put him on the list?
What's less important is that I accepted a recommendation and I made the decision. I accept responsibility for the decision.
You made a decision, according to yourself, as to accepting the termination list. But you've also said you didn't put him on the list. So somebody else other than you, other than the president, other than the vice president, other than every deputy attorney general that's come to this committee, put him on the list. But with all due respect, Mr. Attorney General, you won't tell the American people who put Mr. Iglesias on the list to be fired. It's a national secret, isn't it?
Congressman, if I knew the answer to that question, I would provide you the answer. I have not spoken with the individuals.
Okay, so you don't know who put it on the list, Mr. Iglesias. Why was Mr. Iglesias put on the list by this mystery person?
Well, again, I wasn't surprised to see Mr. Iglesias' name recommended to me based upon conversations that I had with a senior senator from New Mexico. He had lost confidence in Mr. Iglesias. Let me just say, Mr. Iglesias' story is a great one. It's the American dream. And there are many good things about his performance, and I very much admire him as a person.
But you won't tell the American people who put him on a list to terminate his employment.
I accept responsibility for this
decision. You accept responsibility for making the decision ultimately to accept the termination list, but you will not come forth and tell the American people who put Mr. Iglesias on the list to be fired.
Out of respect for the integrity of this investigation and the investigations occurring at the Department of Justice, I have not made that inquiry with respect to other fact witnesses.
But you were okay with firing them, but you won't tell us who made the recommendation to fire him.
I think I was justified in relying upon the senior leadership in the department, as I understood.
Do you know what Mr. Moschella told this committee about why Mr. Iglesias was put on the list? He said the rationale was because he was an absentee landlord. Are you familiar with that?
I'm familiar with Mr. Moschella's public testimony.
Right. He delegated authority, apparently, Mr. Iglesias.
Well, let me just say this. I did not make the decision with respect to Mr. Iglesias.
I know you haven't made any decision, Mr.
Service.
You have been very clear about that.
I accept full responsibility for this.
But you won't tell us who put Mr. Iglesias on that list.
You would have a better opportunity and to access. The committee would.
Are you the Attorney General? Do you run the Department of Justice?
Yes, I do, and it's been frustrating to me to not be able to ask these kinds of questions. But I want to respect the integrity of this investigation and the investigations going on in the department. If we all came up here and had the same...
When did the investigation in the department start?
If we all came up here...
It started after they were fired.
And had the same testimony about events that occurred over 2 years, you would look at that with great suspicion. You would wonder, have you guys talked to each other about facts?
Sir, you know these
reason,
answers.
I have
you
not.
You know them, and it has nothing to do with an investigation that's occurring after these people were fired, because you know the answer before they were fired, because you know who put them on the list, but you won't tell us. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.